Jeff Stein joins us now. He's the host of the Spy Talk podcast and a former national security correspondent at Newsweek. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good to have you with us. I think some people thought maybe they would just go into the eastern part of Ukraine, and here we have surrounded Ukraine and coming from all sides. Did we miscalculate this?
Yeah, I think there was a consensus that the Russians would just limit their opening stages to the Donbas region, claiming taking physical control of territory that is long claimed as Russian property. But what we're now seeing is the opening stages of Russia's version of shock and awe, much like the U.S. invasion of Iraq in 2003. They're looking to decapitate the government in Kiev by taking control of particular strategic buildings and maybe even political personalities in Kiev.
Is there anything for the Western allies to do at this point? Are there any sanctions that would give Putin pause?
Yeah, I think the sanctions can be effective to a degree. I think that's the consensus. Putin and his cronies don't keep their money in banks. You know, they hide that money. So it's and they've been preparing for this for some time. They knew that the U.S. would lay sanctions on them, so they prepared for that. And they've been banking up their cash reserves over the years, so they've thought this out pretty well. Putin may find it's a case of the dog catching the car. He may have bitten off more than he can chew and find himself in difficulty. The U.S. and NATO has been preparing the Ukrainians for partisan warfare, insurgency against the Russian occupation. We'll see how that rolls out.
It seems like Putin's motivation, knowing that this is not good for him financially, is just, in his eyes, to restore Russia to its glory. Do you agree with that? And what can America do? But do we just sit back and watch them go into Kyiv and give it up?
Yeah, we made it clear that Ukraine is not a NATO ally, that we have no treaty obligations to Ukraine. What I fear is that if we start seeing corpses pile up in Kiev and other cities, if we start seeing executions of top Kiev officials, there's going to be an emotional response in the West saying, we got to do something. And that moves us into direct confrontation with the Russians. And, you know, as the two major nuclear superpowers, we don't want to do that. So it's a very tough poker game that both sides are playing now, where the stakes are very, very high.
Putin made a point of saying he did not plan to occupy Ukraine, but wanted to protect its citizens. Do they have the amount of troops that could occupy Ukraine, or is this just for an initial strike?
I doubt you'll see. We don't know. I mean, Putin's game is deception and subversion. I think if he can avoid a troop occupation of Kiev, he's going to do it. He's an ex-KGB guy. He's going to try to capture strategic points in and around Kiev to decapitate the government, round up key political figures in Kiev, and avoid a massive occupation, put puppet government in power, and try to do it that way. We'll see what level of resistance the Ukrainians put up, and see if Putin's plan can be carried out as smoothly as he thinks it can.
A military expert joined us the other day and said it's the equivalent of the Ukrainians being in a knife fight with someone with a gun. Do you think they're that mismatched if they do put up a fight?
Oh, there's no question about that. There's no question. I don't think the vast consensus is that, it's a home game for the Russians. It's right on their border. They can roll across and smash Ukrainian military forces without too much damage, or at least at a level of acceptable damage for them. So the Ukrainians can only put up a fight of resistance and try to bleed the Russians as deeply as they can. But the outlook for this particular fight is not good. The Ukrainians just don't have the guns, the forces to block a Russian invasion.
Jeff Stein from SpyTalk, we appreciate you joining us this morning. Thank you, sir.
Thanks for having me.
We'll continue to follow new developments.